they both suffer deadly wounds and then go into captivity. And so as I close, it's been some years now since Time magazine ran this cover article. And it talked about the Holy Alliance where former President Reagan and former Pope John Paul II worked together to bring down communism. The Pope also got the credit for normalizing relations between Cuba and the USA. The Pope got the credit. Think about that. The most significant political change of the last 100 years was engineered by the leader of a church. And many world leaders, presidents, prime ministers traveled to the Vatican to speak to the Pope. It tells you that something is very different about that church. Friend, I need to press something upon you, and I hope that you can understand what I'm saying. I'm not speaking against individuals, but what we are talking about is a system that blasphemes against God. You see, the reality is the Bible should be our guide and not man. We gain salvation through Christ and not man. Vengeance belongs to God and not man. In the 1880s, two prospectors loaded a shotgun with a few dollars worth of gold dust and blasted it into the walls of a cave near Schaefer Butte. Then they ran down to a bar in Boise and shared with everyone that they had found gold. The proof was in the gold dust embedded in the walls of the mountain from the gunshot blast. And as such, those two men sold the shares in this mine and made big bucks before leaving town, before anyone could find out the con they had pulled on them. Well, that's one version of the story. Another version of the story is the story of Bogus Basin is that Captain Morgan claimed to have found $50,000 worth of gold. However, it was later found out that the gold they found was iron pyrite that had been chemically turned or tuned up to look like gold. Bogus Basin. Whichever one is true, I don't know. But friends of mine, the devil is in the business of selling a counterfeit truth. The devil is giving out bogus salvation. But let us not be deceived by the enemy of souls. There can only be one true God and the way to salvation, and that is through Jesus Christ. And so as I invite you into a real, my desire is to invite you into a real deep relationship with the one who died for you. You see, God's promise tonight is that he offers himself to you, and he's the real deal. He's offering himself to you. And tonight I'm wondering if you'd be willing to say, yes, Lord, I want you in my heart. If that's such a person, won't you raise your hand? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Won't you stand with me as we pray? Lord, we are so grateful for life, for the Bible, for in it, it shows us truth. And yes, there are some message which is heavy and steep and difficult. But Father, if we're not warned, how will we know how to avoid danger? And so as we have sat and listened to these truths, I pray, Father, that you will put blinders of our eyes so that we can keep our eyes fixed on you. But also we want to lift up those who are ignorant of this truth, those who may be living in these religion that don't take you as their Lord and Savior, but have manufactured another version of salvation. We want to pray for them. Lord, we know that they are sincere ones in there. We know that ones in there, they love you with all their heart, but they're ignorant of the truth. And so we want to pray for them. Some of them are members of our family. And God, we want to pray that your spirit will go visit by them. Lord, if you could just tabernacle and allow your spirit to also tabernacle beside them and speak these words of truth into their ears. May they find the truth in the word of God. And may they come and finally recognize that salvation is through Jesus and Jesus alone. Thank you. Fill us once again, I pray, with your spirit, and then bring us back tomorrow to continue sitting at your feet and learning more about you in Jesus' name. Amen.